The mayor's mansion.
The mayor and Mrs. Grant Harrison. Mm-hmm. Oh, would that make me First Lady of Bay City?
Yes, indeed it would. But before you can be First Lady, you have to think yourself a lady, and until
No, please, no more etiquette, no more Martha Stewart tapes, no more lessons on garden party chit-chat and the proper use of the fish fork.
There are no shortcuts to the top, Cynthia.
You want to bet?
What do you mean?
I've been cozying up to the inner circle of Bay City Society. The bullseye of the circle, actually. The Corys. Aren't you proud of me? Oh, you look so wonderful.
I feel 100% better.
Thank goodness. Hmm. John says that you're out of immediate danger.
Yep, I'm gonna be around at least until tomorrow.
And yesterday we were praying you'd survive till today.
Well, you keep up those prayers because they worked. That and all the love and support from everybody.
Oh, my darling.
Don't you look great? Good morning, my heart. Please stay.
Yes, do stay.
You sure you can handle both of us here at the same time?
Hey, it was the two of you together that pulled me through this. I do so want you to be close.
Will you, Mom? I'm trying.
Amanda and I are becoming inseparable.
Well, I wouldn't go quite that far, but...
Hey, listen. I'm living proof that you two are powerful medicine. Now, what's in the bag?
Ah, the doggy bag. Well, these... two chaps. They insisted on tagging along. Oh, I mustn't make you laugh. No, sorry.
Oh, they're adorable. Thank you. You know you're spoiling me something fierce. Hmm? These toys and the flowers last night and the flowers this morning.
Oh, sorry. If you got flowers this morning, it wasn't for me. It must be from somebody else.
Where are they from? Just to see.
Best wishes for a speedy recovery, Mrs. Grant Harrison.
So I got this call from Aunt Franny in New York, right? She's outside again with the scissors cutting the grass along the driveway. She falls down, but breaks her head.
Oh, no.
She's okay. She's okay. She needs some family there for a couple of days just to hang out with her and help her get set up with this whole healthcare worker.
You want me to go?
Well, I can't get away from work and Sophia's got finals. I mean, I know Aunt Franny would love to see her favorite niece, Prunella, and Dante, of course.
Well, I would love to see her, too, but I'm not a nurse.
It's okay. The healthcare person takes care of that. You just have to be there. She just needs family, you know? And you are a full-fledged Carlino, and she would love to see Dante.
Well, I guess since Rachel is recovering, it's okay to leave.
Ah, baby, you're the greatest.
As long as you promise to miss me.
From the minute you walk out the door. Good. So now I know that Aunt Franny's gonna be okay. She's gonna get some nice, good home cooking of yours.
Oh, I hadn't even thought of that.
What's the matter?
Well, every time I'm around your family, it's always eat, eat, eat. I don't mean to be critical, but every problem is solved with manja. It's gonna be murder on my diet.
But honey, your diet is doing fine.
Please.
Hey. You're still sexy as ever.
You're not helping.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. Look. I love that you're so sweet and understanding. It may not be a problem for you, but it is for me. I mean, I hate carrying all this extra weight around. I don't like the way I feel. I don't like the way I look.
What can I do? Just tell me, please.
Praise. Lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of praise.
You got it.
Okay, listen, you go take care of the plane tickets. I'll go by, say goodbye. Say goodbye to Rachel, get packed, and drop this over to Donna at the harbor.
One thing. As soon as Aunt Franny is all squared away, I want my blue eyes back here with me. Understood?
Ow. Yes, sir.
That hurt.
Yes, sir.
I love you.
I love you too. I better get going.
So will you see what I have planned for you for lunch?
You trying to win me over?
I don't know. Is it working?
Well, you know, you got my mother fooled.
What do you mean, fool?
She is talking about you and that comedy club and...
Your mom is a cool lady.
Asking when you're going to come back over.
Oh, really? That's very nice. Very nice. So, how about lunch?
What, with my mother?
No, baby, no. This time, just you and me.
Burrell, got a report on a B&E over at Bayview Towers, Jewelry Heights. Go check it out.
Yes, sir.
What about dinner, then?
We'll try.
Hey, you're forgetting whatever the...
If I am going to play it being Lady of the Manor, I at least need to look the part. I really hate to ask this, but since you won't let me have any credit cards and the checking account you so sweetly opened requires both our signatures, can I have some money for clothes?
Well, that seems a reasonable request.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
What's in the box?
Oh, my grandmother's diamond and emerald necklace. Here, let me show you.
Let me see. Oh, my. And matching earrings?
Yeah.
Ooh, these must cost a bundle.
Yep, I believe the word you're searching for is priceless. But what makes them both special is the regal status that they confer upon the wearer.
Well, confer me some regal status. Come on, let me put them on. I'll wear them to your inaugural ball.
Yeah. Indeed you will, and not until. Come on, we're late for the harvest.
I won't hurt him. Please, 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 please.
No, all right, all right. There you are, darling. Now, you are truly a Harrison.
Yeah, they're heavy.
Yes, the weight of tradition, darling. Decorum, restraint, class. All of these things that you'll learn with practice. A lot of practice.
Grant and his new wife are trying to win respectability by worming their way into a relationship with you.
It's just flowers, Amanda.
Make a statement. Send them back. Paulina, help me out here.
Don't let
them use Mom like this.
Good morning, Rachel.
What? What's going on?
Oh, she's a little upset about some flowers that were sent to me.
Mrs. Grant Harrison.
Oh, well, Cindy's just trying to reach out.
Oh, please.
Well, she's feeling lonely and isolated with Grant. Who wouldn't? And she probably just wants to make friends.
Well, friends like that we don't need, Mom.
I'll tell you what, why don't you take all of the flowers up to pediatrics and give them to the children?
Now, that is a magnificent idea. Don't you agree to that, Amanda?
Oh,
oh, darling.
Go on, darling, do it.
This isn't upsetting you, is it?
No.
Nor me. Come on, Amanda, give me a hand. We'll go and find some children up in pediatrics.
Oh, they don't know what they've got in store for them.
No, they don't. When I heard you made it through the surgery okay, God, I felt like I was holding my breath for days.
So did I.
The thought of losing you.
You haven't lost me. I'm great. I'm healthy. I'm happy. I just can't laugh, that's all.
Oh. Ow! Only hurts when I laugh. And, I'm so glad to hear that. Because guess what?
What?
I have to go to New York.
Oh, how come?
Well, Joe's Aunt Fanny broke her hip. I'm taking Dante, and I'm going to get her set up with a home health care worker, but I wanted to make sure you were okay first.
I'm just fine. You don't have to worry about me. And that's what families are for.
That's what you keep teaching me over and over. What families are for and how they hold us together.
No matter how far apart we are.
I keep thinking about the promise that I made to take care of your baby should anything happen to you.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can make that promise.
Well, you're right. It does have to be amended. I mean, for two babies.
Oh, gosh, I know. The twins, that's so thrilling. But it's not that. It's the thought of me trying to take your place. I could never do that in a million years. Rachel, you're what holds this family together.
The family holds me together. It's all of us working and loving together. That's the power, Paulina, not me.
I don't know about that. Just promise me one thing, that you're not going to go anywhere for a long, long time.
I don't plan to, my darling. I don't plan to.
I love you.
I love you.
I do appreciate your taking care of these contracts for me, Amanda.
Mom wants you with her. That's where you should be.
What do I have to do to prove to you that your mother is my priority?
I'm not looking for a fight here, Carl.
No, not much. That's why you followed me down to Key West, wasn't it? To check up on me, and look what came of that. Bobby Reno's back in prison.
Where he should be.
Facing a lethal injection.
A jury of 12 decided that, not me.
That's right. Yeah, you're not responsible, are you? Not at all. But because of you, a good, innocent man may lose his life. And that's wrong.
I know you want everybody to think that you've turned over a new leaf, Carl, but I don't buy it. Bobby Reno is a convicted murderer. You brought him to our estate and you hid him there. You endangered my mother's life and the rest of the family's.
No one was ever in danger.
How do you know that?
Because Bobby Reno is innocent.
Why? Because he told you?
Because I know so.
Oh. Well, I'm sure that you do understand the criminal mind better than I, but that doesn't cut it with me.
Do you know what I suggest? I suggest, in the interests of family peace, we agree to disagree. God. Felicia.
Amanda, how is she?
She is doing quite splendidly.
Can I go see her?
Yes, you can. You'll never guess that. We're having twins.
You're not.
Twins now.
Twins?
She needs all of our support now.
I'll get along with you for now, for Mother's sake. But I'm keeping my eye on you.
You do that.
I can't believe you're actually going to have twins.
I know. I can't believe it either. I mean, it was enough to consider the challenge of being a new mother, but now I'm doubly challenged.
Well, look at it this way. It's twice the love.
Oh, that's a good way to look at it. Speaking of love, it seems to me I dimly recall before they wheeled me into surgery, you telling me that you were going to get married July 14th.
I just can't believe it. But I come with a request.
What?
You think you could be my matron of honor?
Oh, I would be very honored.
6 weeks, now let's see.
I'll either be as big as a house or I'd be wheeling a double pram down the aisle.
Oh, either way, I don't care. Just be there, my friend.
Nothing could keep me away.
We're talking one upscale cat burglar here. He hit two apartments in Bayview Towers last night.
What's his M.O.?
Strictly professional, in and out, no mess, only big ticket items.
No prints?
No, all he left was his silver rose. I'm assuming it's his calling card.
Great. So this guy's playing games.
Yeah, he's cocky.
Okay, take that down to forensics, have him check it out. I doubt you're gonna pull any prints off that, but you may get lucky with some hairs or fiber, okay?
All right.
Burrell, stay on this. I like this Joker playing games with me.
What?
A table for two, Donna.
I'll see what I can do.
Huh? Huh? You see you're looking at my earrings?
My grandmother's earrings.
Wish you would have let me wear the necklace. Donna would be weeping.
It takes more than jewelry to impress people, darling. Attempt to grasp just how tasteless it would be to wear a diamond and emerald necklace to brunch.
Why have them if you don't wear them? What good are they in a safe?
One saves them for a special occasion, like an inaugural ball, for instance.
If you ever get elected to office.
Count on it. And we'll start small with an intimate dinner party for Bay City's power brokers.
And when we do, I don't want you embarrassing me.
No, see, the embarrassing part will be when no one shows up.
Lose the sarcasm, will you? It makes your upper lip unattractive. As long as I continue writing fat checks to the right social causes, I'll be back on the A-list in no time.
And I will be right there next to you.
No, darling, you'll be at the other end of the table. If you ever earn manners, that is.
Grant, you would think that I just stepped off the farm. What's the big deal?
The big deal is I'm going to turn you into a lady, or you're going to die trying.
I am sick of learning how to use a napkin ring. I think there's a faster way.
Listen to me. No more clumsy overtures to the Coreys, you understand? No more stupid gestures like sending them flowers.
Generosity is the essence of good taste. Read that in the dentist's office.
You'll read. Excellent.
Why don't you take a meeting or something?
What?
Paulina.
Oh, hi. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine. Thanks. Thank you for the flowers that you sent, Rachel. I think she really enjoyed them.
Oh, hey. Friends need to let friends know they care, right?
Have you given any thought to what we talked about the other night, you know, about stopping by sometime?
Well, see...
I know it's awkward right now, but I want you to know how much I really appreciate your company. I don't have a lot of friends in Bay City.
I understand. I'm sure it'll come in time.
Hello, Paulina.
Grant.
Darling, I think Donna has a table for us now.
Oh, you go ahead and have your meeting. I'm going to chat with Paulina for a while.
But I'd really love it if you came with me.
And I would really like to stay here and have lunch with my girlfriend. Won't that be nice? Just the two of us?
I don't know. Okay. How much are the mums?
$10 a dozen.
$10 a dozen. I like that. Oh, wait. How much are the roses right
now? They're 25.
25?
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi. How are you?
Okay.
So, Chris, what do you hear from Jake?
I haven't heard anything from him. Why? Did he fall off the planet again?
Oh, you'd know that better than I. Take a guess.
Knowing my boy, he's probably on the Bobby Reno case, which means he's off with Vicky Hudson somewhere. No. What about those over there?
Yep. Oh, okay. Obsession. What a beautiful thing, huh?
Yeah, tell me about it. I try to talk some sense to the boy. It's like talking to a straw.
Love. It makes you do some really stupid stuff.
Yeah, tell me. You know, Jerry, instead of these, how about 2 dozen of the fancy pink tulip things?
Oh.
There you go.
Oh, okay.
Here's a question for the ages. Why does a man spend his entire life chasing after a woman he knows will never love him back?
It's like the saying goes, you gotta be in it to win it, baby.
Ugh, another romantic, and I thought you were smarter than that.
Yeah. You know what, Jerry? These are nice, very nice, but I'm thinking 4 dozen and she's in the pocket. You know what I'm saying?
I'm going to gag from all the sugar here.
Yeah, well, when are you gonna find true love, or are you planning to spend your golden years alone?
Now, you get your heart broken a couple more times, you won't be asking that question.
Jerry, you know what I'm thinking? No. I'm thinking, no, this isn't doing it for me, but, right there, the one rose, the silver one, right there. I like it.
Now that's classy.
Yes, it is. Thank you very much. I'm a classy man. For you, sir, thank you very much for the trouble. I'm so sorry. There you go. And as for you, you know what? You need to find yourself a man, someone to buy flowers for. I mean, it doesn't make sense for such a beautiful woman to be so evil all the time. Hey, Tony,
yeah.
I'm gonna find you about lunch.
You're not bailing on me, are you?
No, actually, I was wondering how you would feel about a hilltop overlooking Bay City, gentle breeze, sun, boats bobbing in the water, and a gourmet picnic lunch to top it all off.
I feel very good about that.
Oh, yeah?
Let's do it.
I'll see you later.
I will see you there.
All right.
All right.
Until then.
Now I gotta ask you an insightful question.
Morning, Counselor.
Right.
Saw the ad you placed in the law journal.
Oh, yes.
So you're looking for a junior partner, are you?
Caseload is getting pretty heavy.
Ah, well, you want to spend more time with your daughter, I understand that. I miss Kirkland terribly.
We all have our crosses. What's on your mind, Grant?
I'd like to offer you my services. Not as a junior partner, of course. No. I'm talking about a full partner. We'd make a formidable team.
You This is not computing. I can't believe I'm hearing this.
Oh, don't dismiss it out of hand, Counselor. I mean, after all, I have powerful contacts in Washington. You have a sterling reputation. We'd make a good team.
I think I'd rather swallow broken glass.
Well, you may regret not accepting my offer, especially if we meet on opposite sides of the courtroom, Counselor.
Really? Well, I'll take my chances.
Pauline, are you all right?
I'm fine.
Let me get you another table.
No, we're fine here. Just think of this as the ladies who lunch. Right, Paulina?
Donna, I brought by the cannolis. I put them on the bar. I wanted to bring them by before I left for New York.
Thank you, but I think you should get going. You don't want to miss your flight.
Well, I'm thinking eggs Benedict. I love that cream sauce.
Oh, you go ahead. I couldn't.
Oh, come on, my treat.
No, really, thanks. I'm actually watching my weight.
Oh, honey, I know what that's like.
You do?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I didn't always look like this.
I can't believe you used to be heavy.
Big.
Huge.
Then I found my little friends.
Who are your little friends?
Diet pills. A doctor friend of mine prescribed them for me, and the weight came right off.
Cindy, you're a nurse.
Well, I used to be.
Well, how about a little advice?
Well, sure.
I haven't been able to take off this weight since I had Dante. I mean, I've tried diet and exercise, but with my schedule, it's hard to stick to a regimen.
Yeah, of course it is.
I have this wedding to go to, and I would love to fit into a dress that wasn't shaped like a tent. Do you think diet pills would work for me?
You want diet pills?
Well, can you recommend one that might be right for me?
I can do better than that. I still have connections at the hospital. I can get you all the pills you want.
No, thanks. I couldn't do that.
Oh, Paulina, that's what friends are for. You will be svelte and trim and look fabulous for Felicia's wedding.
Thanks.
By the way, do you think you could get me and Grant an invitation?
Well, I don't think so.
Oh, yeah, I know. Not to ask. How about this? You have lunch with me once in a while in public. Maybe go shopping, reserve a good table for Grant and I at Carlino's, and I'll help you with your weight problem. What do you say?
You know, Cindy, I really just wanted some advice. That's all.
Okay. Well, but think about it, okay?
I'm sorry. You know, I really gotta go. I gotta get packed, and I'm leaving, you know, town and
all right.
Everything. So.
All right. Well, hey, maybe when you come back.
Goodbye.
Hey, what are you doing with Mrs. Grant Harrison?
Nothing. I just thanked her for sending Rachel some flowers, you know?
Okay. So I wake up in recovery, and there's Carl holding my hand. I mean, do you think he ever left my side?
No.
No.
It's really amazing what you've done for that man.
I guess my instincts were right about him after all.
Mm.
And the baby.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Mm.
I didn't have any instinct about the babies. Well, whatever it is, something powerful is at work here.
God, I hope so.
We have a lot to be excited about.
Yes.
You're getting married. I'm having twins.
I can't wait. And I also can't wait for you to get well so you can help me plan this thing.
Well, I can hold a clipboard already. Anyway, you're the manager of chaos. You're the expert at it. What?
Oh, it's nothing really. I had this crazy dream the other night. And believe me, I wasn't managing chaos.
What was it about?
It's not important. It really isn't.
Were you thinking about it?
Okay, but you can't laugh.
Okay.
In the dream, I was already married to John and we were on our honeymoon. We were making love. And all of a sudden, John turned into Alexander Ninkos.
Oh,
come on. You're not supposed to laugh. I woke up. I was so guilty about it.
Oh, don't be silly. This is a dream. And besides, it's perfectly normal.
Normal? You think that's normal? I'm going to get married in a few weeks, and I'm dreaming about another man?
I don't think you are dreaming about another man. I mean, he looks exactly like Lucas. You were dreaming about Lucas.
Oh.
You know, I mean, think about it. What's the dream about? It's about the one great love of your life handing you along to the next great love of your life. I mean, it is an adjustment, right?
Right. It's not like I'm falling...
What, in love with a Greek tycoon? I should hope not.
Of course not.
Donna, have you seen Dash?
Oh, no, not yet. Why?
Well, I'm supposed to meet him here for lunch.
Really? Business of pleasure. Actually,
a little of both.
Hi, darling.
Donna.
How are you?
Good. Shall we?
Yes, thanks.
Who's he? Nobody that you know. Paulina and I won't be staying for lunch after all.
Good.
She asked my advice about something and then had to go pack. May I ask you a question, Donna? You are the honorary chair of the Bay City Ladies Arts League, right? I'd like to join. Mrs. Harrison, you will never be a member of the Bay City Arts League or any other club in this town.
How much will it cost me?
You think you can buy your way into polite society?
Oh, can't I?
Let me tell you something. First of all, I think that you're totally insane. And secondly, I will do nothing to help you enable Grant to take Victoria's son away from her.
Oh, Donna, let me let you in on a little secret, shall I? I have no interest in children and absolutely no intention of ever becoming Kirkland's stepmommy.
Then what are you doing?
I'm horse trading. You ready to listen?
Are we keeping you busy enough at Quarry Publishing? I hear you're doing a fine job.
No, I'm not. I come late, I leave early. I much prefer sports to publishing. Publishing doesn't fascinate me nearly as much as you.
How am I fascinating?
Your taste. For instance, this ring. It's lovely. It matches your eyes. They're both lovely. A gift from someone special?
Unfortunately, no. I bought it for myself.
Well, I admire a woman who treats herself well. However, allowing a man to treat her well is also a great honor.
My, you do know how to turn a phrase.
Here's a what if for you. What if I were to ask you out to dinner? What would you say?
I'd say sure. Fine. Sounds wonderful. When?
I'd say here. Now. What say? I have some champagne delivered over to the piano.
A man with talent.
A dedication to a lady of taste.
Hi.
Hello there. Who's the new piano man?
He's a friend of the family. He's an Earl's son.
Oh, son of Earl.
Got tired of Carlino's?
Actually, I came by here to make sure you hadn't forgotten our bowling date.
I was hoping that you had. Can't we do something more civilized, like polo or sailing?
Donna,
or
what? I live to see you in a bowling shirt and a pair of those funky old shoes.
I'm sure you do. Talk about changing images. Oh, speaking of images, Cindy Harrison was here. Let me tell you what she was trying to say to me. Let me just have lunch with you, Mike.
No.
Hi, Annie.
Oh,
I'm afraid he's mine for lunch. Hi.
Sorry, Princess, but I will see you at the Bolarama.
Anything for you, Cass.
She obviously is after something. What is
she
it?
She wants a man, you know. She's lonely. I know how that feels.
You know what? Right after I get married, I'm going to work on your love life.
Honey, right after you get married, aren't you supposed to go on your honeymoon?
You know what I mean. Anyway, I have something I have to ask you, all right?
Yeah.
Will you give me away again?
Honey.
Will you?
I'd be honored.
Oh,
how many times does this make
it?
I've given you, and you
there.
Just keep coming right back to me.
Yes, but this time it's going to be for good. Anyway, tell me about you. Have you gotten any response from your ad?
Oh, yes, and from the strangest sources. Grant Harrison, for example, if you can believe that. And then right in the middle of everything, I got a letter from Alexander Nikos asking me to reconsider and go on retainer full-time as his attorney. I mean, this guy will not give up. When he wants something, he wants it.
And
Donna Love is going to sponsor me as a member of the Ladies Arts League.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
How the hell did that happen?
Oh, it was simple. I just told her I'd keep you away from Kirkland so that Vicky wouldn't worry about losing custody.
And what kind of an idiotic promise was that? Who the hell do you think you are?
It was a lie. A little white lie was all it took to get your ex-mother-in-law to hold me up as the newest bright light of Bay City society.
You will make no promises concerning my son, not even phony ones.
Are you forgetting that I am just as low and sneaky as you are, Grant?
I'm warning you, you make no moves without my permission.
I am capable of making friends and influencing people
on
my own.
You are capable of doing nothing more or less than I tell you to. Now, why don't you tell me just who you think you have influenced in my absence?
I feel like getting out of these clothes and your grandmother's precious jewelry.
Treat them gently, please.
Okay, folks, right this way. Mr. Harrison, please take a seat.
Thank you.
Joe, hi, how's Bobby?
She's fine, thank you.
You are damn good. You're almost as good as me.
Well,
good girl.
I'm glad you're impressed. Looks like we're going to be having our lunch at the precinct cafeteria.
Hey, as long as it's you, me, and some food, I don't care.
Okay. Sounds good. So, Mr. Harrison, there was no forced entry. Is there any chance that your wife pulled this heist?
Absolutely not. I trust my wife implicitly.